Hi, this is Rob. I'm going to go over the settings that I use to make 4K time-lapse videos internally in the Panasonic LX100 camera. This time-lapse video is in front of the City Hall building in Valencia, Spain. The Panasonic LX100 has a built-in time-lapse shot feature in which you can set the number of shots taken, and the LX100 will combine those shots into a time-lapse video in 4K or 1080 and in frame rates of your choosing, and make that video in camera. Let's take a look at the settings I use to make 4K time-lapse videos in the LX100. You need a steady tripod to make time-lapse videos. I have this large one here, and I also use this mini tripod called the UltraPod 2. This mini tripod works well with the LX100, and I made a video about this mini tripod, and I'll put a link in the description below. Since we're using a tripod, let's turn off the image stabilizer in the camera. On the LX100, you can change the aspect ratio of the photos taken. The options are 3:2, 16:9, 1:1, and 4:3. For time-lapse videos, make sure you change the aspect ratio to 16:9. The SD card that I'm using is 64GB Class 10 UHS Speed Class 3 SD card. This UHS Class 3 is what you want when recording regular 4K video, and thus what you should have for the LX100 camera. But when making 4K time-lapse videos, you shouldn't need a UHS Speed Class 3 card. A UHS Class 1 should do, because you're just taking a series of photos. I have not tested this out, so if somebody has a Class 1 card and has done time-lapse videos on the LX100 and 4K, let us know how it performs in the comments below. The ISO. I like to use the ISO 100 whenever possible. The lighting conditions will dictate which ISO setting you need. Silent mode. I like the silent mode on the LX100, and I use it for everything. It is especially nice when taking time-lapse shots, because no one can hear the shutter, and thus making it a little easier to make time-lapses in public places. I usually take photos in RAW format, but when taking time-lapse shots, I like to change the quality to fine. There's a quick way to do that. Go to the Cue menu by pressing the Cue button. Move over to the quality settings here. Move down. This 4575 number is the number of raw quality shots that my 64GB SD card can hold. So that is the main reason that I am going to switch to fine quality, to increase the number of shots that my SD card will hold. Now, the number of shots that my SD card will hold is 9,321. I just doubled the number of shots that my SD card will hold. Move up. Now we're going to do one more thing to increase the number of shots that my SD card will hold and still produce 4K time-lapse videos. Go here to picture size. We're going to change from large size, which is 11MB photo at a 16:9 aspect ratio, to a medium size, which is an 8MB photo. A medium-sized photo with 8MB is still large enough to produce a 4K time-lapse video. Notice that the number of shots that the SD card can currently hold is 9,321. Change to medium size. Now we can hold 11,763 shots for our time-lapse videos. Go up. Press the center button to set the new settings. Now we need to go into the time-lapse shot menu to set the shooting interval and the image count. You can find it here. Press enter. Go down to shooting interval and image count. Hit enter. Here's where we can choose the shooting interval, the time between shots taken. You can choose minutes and seconds. I'll choose seconds. 3 seconds is good for clouds, and 1 second is good for people walking. I'm going to use 1 second interval. I usually use a 1 second interval for most of my time-lapse videos. Image count. You can set the number of shots that will be taken. I usually shoot 750 images. 750 images with a frame rate of 30 frames per second will give you a 25-second time-lapse. Taking the number of images and divide it by the frame rate will give you the time of the time-lapse video. If you want your time-lapse to be 24 frames per second, then it will give you a 31-second time-lapse. I usually use 30 frames per second. Thus, every 150 frames will give you a 5-second time-lapse at 30 frames per second. Okay, you see this end time right here, 1421 or 2:21 p.m. If we would start the time-lapse recording right now, it would finish at this time. For 750 images at 1 second interval, it happens to be 12.5 minutes of recording time. I wish Panasonic would change that to state the actual recording time. If you are using 1 second intervals, then take 750 shots and divide it by 60 seconds per minute, and it equals 12.5 minutes. Press enter to set the interval and image count. Start time. You can set a start time for the time-lapse shots to begin recording, either now, or you can set a time for later. It is a 24-hour clock that is synced up with the time set in the camera. If you set a time for a couple of hours from now, initiate the time-lapse feature, the camera would turn off and then turn back on a few minutes before the start time. Here I set the start time at 17:15 or 5:15 p.m. and you can see the end time is 12 minutes later at 17:27. I usually don't use this feature, so I'm going to set the start time to now. The time-lapse data is all set. I now want to set the camera aperture, shutter time, and manual focus. To get out of this screen, press the return button. Most people who do time-lapse videos recommend that you use full manual for everything. I like to use a shutter speed of 1/60th of a second. I leave the aperture set to automatic for the time being and set the shutter speed to 1/60th of a second. Then I take a meter reading using the camera at the subject I want to take time-lapse shots. Press the shutter halfway down. You see that flashing 1660? The 16 is the aperture the camera will use if I keep the aperture on automatic. I am also setting the focus when I do this. I will now change the aperture to 16. The focus has already been set when I pressed the shutter halfway down before. Now I will switch to manual focus. Be careful when switching to manual focus and do not hit this manual focus ring. If you do, then you just knocked it out of focus. Okay, now it is time to start the time lapse. Go to the menu, click on time lapse shot, click on start, press the shutter button to start. Now at any time during the time lapse process, if you need to stop or pause, just press this FN2 button. Now you see this continue, pause, or end. I'll select end. End time-lapse shot? No, I want to continue. It has been 12.5 minutes and all of my time-lapse images are complete and we get this window. Create video now. I usually select yes. Here's where you can choose the recording quality, frame rate, and sequence of the time-lapse video. For recording quality, you can choose 4K 30p, 4K 24p, HD 60p, HD 30p, or VGA 30p. For frame rate, you can choose 60 frames per second, 30 frames per second, 15 frames per second, 10 frames per second, 7.5 frames per second, 6 frames per second, 3 frames per second, or 1 frame per second. I usually use 30 frames per second. For sequence, you can choose a normal or reverse. Normal is using the first frame shot as the start of the time lapse and going forward. Reverse is using the last frame shot as the start of the time lapse and going backwards. I use normal. Now choose OK to start processing the time lapse. Then this window pops up giving you an estimated time to make the time lapse video. I have 750 shots and the camera is estimating that it will take 10 minutes to create the time lapse. I found this to be way overestimating. It usually only takes about 2 to 3 minutes to process 750 shots into a time lapse video. Choose yes. They give you a status bar to see the progress of the time-lapse creation. When the time-lapse is finished processing, you will see this play video screen. Just click on the upper part of the control wheel to begin playing your new time-lapse video. On the left of the screen, you can see the number of seconds ticking away. 25 seconds is the length of this time-lapse video. Okay, that's it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to this channel. Here's the time-lapse that I shot in Valencia, Spain. This was shot as 4K, but downsized to 1080, and I added this zooming effect in post-processing. This is one of the advantages of shooting a 4K time-lapse. It allows you to do some zooming in or zooming out and still get a nice HD video.